Welcome to this demonstration of the AMD Vitis High-Level Synthesis HLS Overview. This demonstration highlights key features related to the HLS design flow within the AMD Vitis Unified IDE. Let's begin by launching the Vitis Unified IDE. The Vitis Unified IDE is a comprehensive development environment for heterogeneous system design, supporting a bottom-up approach where individual system elements are designed as components. Upon opening the IDE, the Welcome tab presents various development flows, including HLS, AI Engine Graph, Embedded, and System Development, alongside tools for report analysis and user-managed workflows. The Welcome tab also provides access to tutorials and user guides, allows you to set up new workspaces or clone repositories for project initiation, and displays a list of recent workspaces for quick access. To create an HLS component, navigate to the toolbar, click File, hover over New Component, and select HLS. This opens the Create HLS Component wizard, which guides you through the process. For this demonstration, we'll be using a discrete cosine transformation, DCT example. The algorithm is fully described in C. Essentially, it uses a two-dimensional DCT algorithm by applying a one-dimensional DCT to each row of the input array and then applying the same one-dimensional DCT to the columns of the resulting array. In the wizard's Name and Location page, enter DCT as the component name and browse to the desired path for component creation. This will name the HLS component and populate the associated directories and files within the component location. Click Next to proceed to the Configuration File page and select Empty File. Leave the remaining fields at their default settings. This action creates a new configuration file named HLS_config. The HLS component configuration file stores commands and settings for the component's synthesis, simulation, and export. The Create HLS Component wizard offers three methods for adding a configuration file. Empty file. This option creates a new empty configuration file, which you can populate after component creation. You specify the name of the new configuration file in the New Configuration File Name field. Existing file. This option utilizes an existing configuration file. You can enter the file's path and name directly in the File field or use the Browse button to locate it. Generate from Vitis HLS project. This option generates a configuration file from an existing Vitis HLS project's HLS.app file. You select the HLS.app file and provide a new configuration file name for the generated configuration file. Click Next to advance to the Source Files page. In the Design Files section, use Add Files to select the primary source file or Add Multiple Files. Specify the top function, which is the function to be synthesized as the top-level function for the HLS component. Any underlying functions called by the top function will also be synthesized into RTL. In the Test Bench Files section, use Add Files or Add Folders to add Test Bench and associated files. For both Design and Test Bench files, you can specify C flags and C sim flags to control compilation and simulation directives. These directives can be applied globally to all files or specifically to individual files within each category. Click Next to advance to the Part page, where you'll select the target part for the HLS component and then click Next again to proceed. The subsequent Settings page presents options for configuring the clock period, clock uncertainty, flow target, and package output format. For this example, set the clock period to 10 nanoseconds and retain the default clock uncertainty. It's important to note that during synthesis, the tool automatically applies some margin in the form of uncertainty. This uncertainty time helps create RTL that is more likely to meet timing in vivado place and route. The settings page also allows you to choose the flow target for the HLS component build process, selecting either vivado IP or Vitis kernel. Select vivado IP flow target from the drop-down list. Below the flow target, you can define the package output format. The default Vivado IP setting generates a .zip file, which can be added to your IP catalog, enabling the integration of HLS-generated RTL designs into other projects. Click Next to move to the Summary page. This page displays a summary of your selections from the previous pages. After reviewing the summary, click Finish to create the component. Once created, the component's vitis-comp.json file opens in the central editor window, and the HLS component is activated in the Flow Navigator. To effectively utilize the Vitis Unified IDE for HLS development, understanding its GUI panes is crucial. The Vitis component's view provides a hierarchical navigation of your project, organizing source files and test benches within expandable subfolders. From this view, files can be opened and their contents displayed in the information pane, which also serves to present report summaries. During synthesis or simulation, the output view will display the process results. Furthermore, the flow view offers access to the commands and processes necessary to guide your source code through simulation, synthesis, and final output export. Depending on your specific development needs, additional views such as the HLS directive and HLS module hierarchy views can be opened to provide more granular control and insight. To view the HLS component's source code, expand Sources and click dct.c file. For the test bench, expand Test Bench and click dct.test.c file. This shows a self-checking mechanism comparing output to a golden result, reporting pass or fail. With the HLS component active, the Flow Navigator enables C synthesis, C simulation, C to RTL co-simulation, packaging, and implementation for building and analyzing the component. To run C simulation with default settings, click Run under C simulation. The simulation progress can be observed in the output window. Upon completion, a summary report detailing the simulation command and timestamp is generated. This report and the simulation log file can be viewed under the report heading or in the analysis view. Next, to synthesize the design using default settings, navigate to the flow view and select the active HLS component from the component drop-down list. Initiate the synthesis process by clicking Run under C Synthesis. The synthesis log can be monitored in the Output tab. For a detailed synthesis report, expand the DCT HLS output SYN report hierarchy within the Vitis components window and click dctcsynth.rpt. This will display the synthesis report, allowing you to review the critical performance estimates and utilization estimates for your design. Following the high-level synthesis of the C design, the next step involves performing RTL co-simulation to verify the generated RTL against the C test bench. The co-simulation, essentially a simulation verification, aims to ensure that the software, CC++ code, and RTL code produce identical results. To initiate this process, navigate to the flow view. Select the active HLS component from the component drop-down list and click Run under C to RTL co-simulation. The simulation log can be monitored in the Output tab. For a detailed report, expand the DCT HLS, Output, Sim, Report, Hierarchy within the Vitis Components window and open dctcosim.rpt. Alternatively, this report can also be accessed directly from the flow window under C to RTL co-simulation. Reports. Co-simulation. With the design successfully validated through simulation and co-simulation, the next step is to package it into a reusable IP component. To begin, navigate to the flow view and select the active HLS component from the component drop-down list. Initiate the packaging process by clicking Run under Package. The packaging log can be observed in the Output tab. The package options provide flexibility in choosing the output format, including Vivado IP. Here the IP is exported as a zip file that can be added to the Vivado IP catalog. The IP folder found within the implementation directory contains the contents of the unzipped IP. Vitis kernel.exo file output can be used for linking by the Vitis compiler in the application acceleration development flow. You can link the Vitis kernel with other kernels and the target accelerator cards to build the XCL bin file for your accelerated application. Vivado IP for system generator. The IP is exported as a zip file that for use with the Vivado edition of system generator for DSP. RTL. This option creates Verilog and VHDL folders in the HLS component working directory and allows you to skip generating packaged IP or XO modules, saving time during initial design iterations. High-Level Synthesis HLS provides estimations for the generated RTL design, including resource utilization and timing. However, these are projections. For accurate RTL analysis, you should run Vivado RTL Synthesis and place and route to check actual results. Vivado Synthesis and implementation can be configured before execution using the implementation settings. This step verifies that the RTL meets estimated timing and area goals, and these results are not included in the exported package. To summarize in this demonstration, you have learned how to create an HLS component in the AMD Vitis Unified IDE. You also learned how to add source files, specify component settings, run C simulation, synthesize the design, validate the design with C to RTL co-simulation, and export the design as AMD Vivado Design Suite IP.